Today we are going to discuss about the biodiversity. Biodiversity, also known as the biological diversity, this is the term that describes about the variety of living things. Discuss about the variety of living beings. On Earth. Right? So, biological diversity that encompasses the different types of the microorganisms, plants, animals, and ecosystem. Such as the forest or deserts or coral reefs, etc. So it represents the wealth of biological resources that is available to us. Also, the biodiversity is the foundation of the ecosystem service to which human well-being is intimately linked. So, biodiversity refers to two types of ecosystem. One is known as the managed ecosystem. Managed ecosystem, such as the plantation, farms, croplands, aquaculture. Unmanaged ecosystem. Like nature preserve. Wildlife. Nature parks. This biological diversity that began to be caused during the period in 1980, and in 1992, with the interest in the concept elevated by the publication such as the New Earth Summit, the word biodiversity that is often attributed to W.G. Rosen. So, now we discuss about the, what are the elements of biodiversity. Elements of biodiversity. Over the last 30 years, many different organizations and scientists and biological society have given different types of definition about the biodiversity. In 1992, in the Convention of Rio Arts Circle, that biological diversity is opened. That is a diverse of biological resources. However, there are differential elements of the biodiversity, like genetic diversity, this genetic diversity corresponds to the variety of genes contained in plants, animals, microorganism, it is. And this genetic diversity that may occur within species as well as between the species, within species and between the species. Second, ecosystem diversity. This ecosystem diversity, it refers to all the different habitats that exist. Different habitats. Like tropical forest, temperate forest, cold desert, hot desert, etc. So this is corresponds to a series of complex relationships between the living components, such as the plants and animals, biotic or abiotic components, etc. And the third one is the species diversity. This diversity is the variety of different species, like suppose elephants, bacteria, it can be counted by the species richness. That is the number of species, and species evenness. That is the measurement of how evenly individual are distributed among species. So species richness that describe about the number of species, and species evenness that describe about the how evenly they are distributed among the species. So there are different types of measurement has been done to
to estimate the biological diversity. One is known as the alpha diversity. This alpha diversity, that is the species diversity within an area. For example, species diversity within this plot, or in species diversity within a measurement in a hectare. So, what are the diversity of species within this plot or hectares that can be estimated through the alpha diversity? Beta diversity. It compares the species diversity between location. Compares the species diversity between location. Like compares between the community, compares between the ecosystem, for example, what is the diversity between tropical ecosystem and the temperate ecosystem? This type of measurement can be done through beta diversity. And third one is the gamma diversity. It describes the overall species diversity. So what is the importance of this biodiversity study? Like maintaining the balance of an ecosystem. That is, recycling a storage of the nutrients, or combating the pollutions and stabilizing the climate, etc. Forming and protecting the soil. In this way, it can maintaining the balance of an ecosystem. Social benefits. Like recreation and tourism, cultural value. By increasing the education or the research work. In this way, it can increase its social benefits. Industry. Biological resources provide many industrial metals like fiber, wool, rubber, water, timber, paper, etc. Provision of biological resources. That is, provision of medicine and pharmaceuticals, food, ornamental plants, wood products, etc. That can be attained from the different types of biological resources. Biodiversity and culture. That is, biodiversity enhances the recreational activities like bird watching, fishing, trekking, etc. Recently, biodiversity is under serious threats due to the increasing population, resource consumption, climatic change, global warming. Habitat conversion, urbanization, over-exploitation of natural resources, environmental degradation. There are several causes that is giving a threat of biological diversity and the biological resources in our Earth surface. Therefore, we need to protect of the biological biodiversity to get the social benefits, cultural benefits, and other biological resources from our nature, from our Earth surface. Thank you for watching this video.